What's going on, guys, and welcome back to the channel for another Football Manager 2021 Rebuild Challenge. Today, we are taking on the challenge of rebuilding Tottenham. Now, I have a rough history with Tottenham. I was the manager of Spurs during my Glory Hunter series, and they sacked me. So, this is going to be an interesting one. Obviously, rebuilding Tottenham is a bit of a difficult one. They started the Premier League season very, very well this year, but then have sort of fallen off a little bit with losing games to Chelsea, Palace and Arsenal in a row. The issue I've now got is obviously what to do with Harry Kane. So it's going to be an interesting one. But before we dive in to today's episode, I just want to say thank you to all the new subscribers, which are running up the left-hand side of the video right now. I just want to say thank you to all you guys who have joined the channel over the past week. It really does make a big difference to me. Obviously, seeing you guys join the channel and join the community is a massive thing. I love having each and every single one of you here. So thank you very much to all the guys scrolling up the left-hand side of the screen. But without any further ado, let's dive in. This is the Tottenham Hotspur rebuild, and we're going to start off with the transfers because I've actually signed somebody. Obviously, there's some loans and, you know, all the transfers that start off at the start of a game of Football Manager. So, you know, we've still got Joe Hart, we've still got Højbjerg, Doherty we've signed, Reguilon we've signed, Gareth Bale is here on loan, Carlos Vinicius is in on loan, but we've also signed Odard, I always butcher this guy's name, from Celtic. 17 million did I spend? 22.5 million for this guy from Celtic. Obviously, Frenchman, very prolific in Football Manager. I love his stats. Great finishing, great composure, pretty good physicals, nice off the ball, good work rate. As an advanced forward, I think he can really offer us something. I think as well, he probably will end up playing some game time on both the right and the left side. We are playing wingers this time around in this tactic. And I think, you know, three-star current ability isn't too bad. A lot of the team is being judged on the ability of Harry Kane. And when Harry Kane does get injured, like he will at some point in this season, in every season, it would imagine, he can step in. And I think he's a good option to drop back and sort of cover when Harry Kane is out of the team. Obviously, we do still have players like Heung-Min Son, but I think another backup striker is definitely needed, and I think he is a level above where we were currently at. If we go into the tactic for today's video, what we are going to be running is the GYRFM 4-3-3 Avalanche. This is an absolute monster of a tactic. I kind of wanted the defensive midfielder because, as I said, I've been sacked by Tottenham before, and I really, really don't want to get sacked by Spurs. This is a great little tactic. If we pick the best 11, this is what you're looking at right now. So obviously, I know I've spent 20 odd million on a backup player, but I think the depth will help us throughout the course of the season. We've got Hugo Lloris in goal, Serge Aurier, Eric Dier, Alderweireld, Reguilon, Højbjerg, Ndombele, Lo Celso, Bale, Heung-Min Son, and Harry Kane. Obviously, everyone being judged on the star ratings off of the ability of this man right here, Harry Kane. Obviously, I know he was under a large transfer issue in the summer. Was he going to go to Man City? Is he going to go to Man City? He didn't. He stayed at Spurs. We're going to keep hold of him. But in every save of mine, he either ends up going to Liverpool or PSG. So you never know. If a bid comes in, I'd definitely listen to bids for Harry Kane in a bid to rebuild this whole team. The players in this team that I think will probably be untouchable don't span very far. I think it'll just be Reguilon and Son. To be honest, everyone else needs to sort of prove their worth. So this is going to be an interesting one to see how season one goes. Obviously, in terms of all the competitions, we are in the Premier League, we are in the Europa League, we are in the FA Cup, and we are in the Carabao Cup. And in terms of that club vision, we've got some club culture things to adhere to as well. But in terms of the goals for the current season, they want us to reach the semi-finals of the Europa League, qualify for the Champions League and the Premier League, reach the semi-finals of the FA Cup, and they do not care about the Carabao Cup. But this one's quite an interesting one. Work towards becoming self-sustainable. That's going to be an interesting one. Obviously, they're going to have stadium repayments and stuff like that. In terms of the finances, let's make that budget adjustment right now. There we go. That cuts us in the wage budget, and we have no more transfer budget, because if we go into the debts and loans, as you can see, Spurs have a net debt of £750 million. Now, I imagine a large portion of this is because of the stadium. Obviously, we are making repayments on this. It's steep. We're making repayments of £25 million a month. Yikes. This is something people don't think about, guys. They think about, you know, you go to a Premier League club, the TV money's there. They've got some state money that they're paying back. That's ridiculous. Until the 1st of April next year, 2021. Interesting. Okay. So once we've paid that back, fingers crossed, we can sort of start sorting things out. The overall balance of the club is actually quite high, but I didn't realize Spurs were in that much debt. Obviously, it's because of the stadium. I understand it. It makes sense. But that's maybe why they're faltering in real life, yeah, on the pitch. So that is what we're going for. Obviously, the title is going to be an interesting one. Let's go into the Premier Division and look at things. Obviously, you don't need to see the stages because nobody's played a game yet. And Harry Kane is the only player who makes it into the team of the Dream 11. Sorry, the media Dream 11. We are currently predicted to finish in fifth at 20-1 odds of winning the title. This is going to be an interesting one. I'll see you at the end of season one, guys. Right, then we are back at the end of season one, and we have cracked it into that top four. Chelsea are the team that makes way. So the top four is Liverpool, who win the Premier League title with 92 points, Manchester City, Manchester United, and then Spurs. 10 draws is really, really irritating, to be perfectly honest. Some teams in there that we've drawn against that we should beat. Draws, two draws against West Ham, the draw against Southampton, Villa. There's definitely games in here that are winnable that would have propelled us a little bit higher up the table and probably into second potentially if we won some of those games. Chelsea finish 11 points behind us in fifth. Arsenal down in ninth, so that's interesting. In terms of teams relegated, let's have a look at the bottom of the table. West Ham, Newcastle, who have just been purchased at the time I'm recording this. They've been purchased, so that's going to be an interesting one moving forward. That's a rebuild job for FM22, isn't it, if they get their finances done in time. And West Brom have gone down. Harry Kane, top goal scorer for me in the Premier League with 27 goals. Most assists coming to Son as well. Europa League, not great. Knocked out in the second knockout round by Chelsea. Looks like we were done on away goals. It's never a good way to go out there, is it? Disappointing. The three away goals that we give up at the Tottenham Hotspur Stadium are the one that knock us out. But if you have a look at this, I imagine Chelsea got knocked out of the Champions League, which they did, in a group with Bayern Munich and Marseille. That's a disappointing result. Chelsea should really go through in that instance. So I think we were relatively unlucky to come across a team the size of Chelsea in the Europa League second knockout round, but they understandably are going to be a little bit disappointed with me for that. Knocked out in the fifth round of the FA Cup by Preston North End, and knocked out in the fourth round of the Carabao Cup by Watford. We expand the Premier League table just a little bit. I'm going to take a look at a couple things. 83 goals scored is actually quite impressive. 43 goals conceded, that's where we've got an issue. I think we need to tighten things up. The 40 goal difference isn't too bad, but we really need to tighten things up to stop some of these sloppy draws happening. Conceding two goals at home to Leeds, probably shouldn't be doing that. Yeah, definitely some stuff that needs to be tightened up here. And I think, you know, we go out and we buy some defenders and we come back for season number two. Okay then, guys, so season two is about to start, and I'm going to start initially by talking about the transfers, and this is a big one. Liverpool came in for Heung-Min Son, and he wanted to leave Tottenham. I don't know how this would play out in real life, but he said he wanted to leave Spurs, so we sold him for a decent chunk, 80 million, and I believe most of it was up front from memory. He's going to be a deadly force at Liverpool. He really is. They've just won the Premier League. He obviously wanted to go there. So 80 million, we recruit some good money for him, and we put it to good use, if you ask me. So we've spent 45 million. So obviously we had the 80 from Son plus our own transfer money anyway. We had the 80, we spent some money, Frank Kessie, 45 million on the Ivorian central midfielder from AC Milan. He is very, very good, very physical, good stamina, good strength, pretty good pace as well at 15, actually pretty good mentally, then really good as a box to box midfielder. I felt like we needed someone in that position, and Frank Kessie was a name at the top of my list. We needed a center back. I don't like Eric Dyer and Alderweireld as a center back partnership. It's just not for me. So we went out and signed Jose Jimenez from Atletico Madrid, the Uruguayan, an absolute truck of a man. Really good where he needs to be, pretty good physically for someone of his sort of build and stature. Nice tackling, good marking, good heading as well. Ball playing defender, I think he could be a real step up from what we've had there previously. If you look at the player comparison, he is 4 stars. Dyer and Alderweireld are 3 stars respectively. So I feel this is a big, big step up, actually signing an elite center back, as the media description says, to play there. Also to help shore up things in the defensive position, we've signed Wilfred Ndidi from Leicester. We paid 40 million to Leicester City for Wilfred Ndidi. I just want him here as this central defense midfielder, just to sit and break up play. That's all I need him to do. I don't need him to do anything else. Just sit and break up the play, my dude. At the other end of the field, we did sign some players as well. Another player from Dynamo Kiev, 29 million spent on this guy. Viktor Chesgankov is how I'm going to say that name. Or Yankov. Sure. He's a Uruguayan international, comes in, can play on the right-hand side as that inverted winger. Good dribbling, good first touch, good passing, great technique. It's kind of what I wanted him for. I want him to be direct, want him to run at people. As you can see again from the comparison, he is an improvement in that position. And then to play on the other side, to replace Heung-Min Son, we have signed Rafael Leao from AC Milan. AC Milan getting a decent amount of money from us, it would appear, in this transfer window. A little bit more direct than Son, I would say, in terms of his physical. 17 pace and 16 agility and acceleration is going to cause a lot of trouble for teams. Great dribbling, great first touches, where he can put the ball in the back of the net, which is a bonus because we've kept Harry Kane for this transfer window. So I'm intrigued to see if we can not only keep hold of Harry Kane, but also continue to build and be better than that fourth place finish last season. If we go into the competitions, obviously we did finish inside the top four, so we are into the Champions League this year, not the Europa League, and we enter that at the group stage. In terms of the vision, guys, we are working towards this five-year plan and the club culture. This is quite thick, this one. They want us to reach the quarterfinals of the Champions League in our first season back at it. That's going to be tough. Qualify for the Champions League again via the Premier League. FA Cup semi-finalists is what they want, and also Carabao Cup is not important, but coming up soon, they want us to start challenging for the Premier League title, and that's kind of what I want to do this year. I feel like we are a much better team than we were last year. If we look at the season preview, the odds kind of do think that. We were 20-1 last season to win the Premier League. We're now 12. The odds have shortened, but they still have us predicted to finish fifth, and we've spent some money, guys. We have spent some cashola. We've still only got Harry Kane in that media dream 11. Okay, we're back in the Champions League. This is going to be an interesting distraction. I feel like we're a better team than we were last season. Let's go to the end of season two. I will be back at that end of the season. Okay, guys, so we are back at the end of season two, and we did improve. We were better than last season. We got 79 points in the Premier League, and we finished third. Last season, we finished fourth, I believe, with 76 points. Let's have a look at the stages. Yes, 76 points, and we finished fourth in season number one. Season number two, we finished third, obviously qualified for the Champions League again. 24 wins, 7 draws, 7 losses. Compare it to last season, we lost one less. We lost one more, drew less, and we won more games, which is good. It's a positive end. Obviously, Manchester United just beating us there, beating us to it on goal difference to finish as runners-up to Liverpool, who again won the Premier League title. Man City dropping down into fifth is absolutely ridiculous. Anthony Martial scored 35 goals in the Premier League, which is crazy. But again, it looks like we've conceded a lot of goals. 40 goals to concede is a lot. And the fact that Hugo Lloris is nowhere near the top of the clean sheet table, 17 for De Gea, 16 for Edison respectively, is something that we're probably going to have to address at some point, because obviously Lloris is not getting any younger. I just have to look, just out of curiosity. Heung-Min Son, they're playing him at striker, and he scored 23 goals in all competitions for them. Fair play, Heung-Min, fair play. In terms of the other competitions, though, we've entered the Club World Championship for some reason. I don't know why that's happened. We were knocked out of our Champions League group by Bayern and AC Milan, despite buying two of AC Milan's best players. They powered through. Donnarumma's a monster in this, I will say. Absolute beast. But we go out annoyingly on goal difference, which meant we dropped into the Europa League. And we met Valencia in that first knockout round. And we were knocked out by Valencia on away goals again after a 5-5 draw. Really disappointing. But we move. We move. European football, we've not cracked it. 4 points away from winning the Premier League is good. I feel it's a progression. Winning trophies with Tottenham is going to be difficult, only because the Premier League is so hard. Obviously, selling one of our best players to Liverpool again doesn't really help a title rival. In terms of the domestic trophies in England, knocked out in the fifth round of the FA Cup by Manchester United. We lost that tie 4-2, and knocked out in the quarterfinals of the Carabao Cup by Chelsea. I know the board don't care about the Carabao Cup, but it would be nice to win Spurs a trophy, wouldn't it? It really, really would. Really would. So no additional transfers in the January window. We're just powering forward, guys. It is time for the summer transfer window going into season number 3. Be back in a sec. So then we are back for season number 3 and we have strengthened yet again. I wanted to add more depth to those defensive positions. I think the addition of Jimenez really did help, but I think he needed a player to play alongside him. That's why we spent 65 million on Ibanez. This Brazilian guy is a beast. He genuinely is. We bought him from Roma. He's fantastic in all the areas he needs to be. I'm not worried about these orange arrows at all. He will figure that out very, very soon. An elite level center back as well, if you ask me. Him to play alongside Jimenez. One's 4-star, one's 4.5-star. 3.5-star, sorry. That is a vast improvement from Eric Dier, to be perfectly honest. So that's why we paid some money for him. 17 million, which could rise to 26 million for Hans Hatterboer, the right back. Dutch international, obviously from Atalanta. I just needed someone that wasn't Serge Aurier to play on that side. Matt Doherty also not really cutting the mustard. I kind of want someone who can attack and actually deliver the ball into the penalty area whilst also actually being able to defend as well. So I went for Hatterboer. He was unhappy at Atalanta. Really nice physically. He's got the attributes that I'm looking for along with that 12 crossing and 11 passing. I think he can add something else. But this is where you're going to say it started to get silly, guys. Eduardo Camavinga comes in. We spent £70 million on him from Rennes. I wanted to move now for Camavinga rather than at the end of season 3. I think that added sort of body in that midfield. Young, hungry, can tackle, can break up the ball, can pass the ball as well as a deep line playmaker. I think he's really good. Obviously, he's really good. He turns into an absolute monster in FM. Just to show you guys the tactic and sort of the best 11 that we are working with now, this is kind of where we are. So we've still got Lloris in goal. I wanted to replace Lloris. Obviously, he's now down to 2.5-star ability, according to my coaches. But Livakovic, who I wanted to sign, had already gone to Porto, so I could not do that. So this is the starting 11 as our best 11. So Lloris in goal, Hatterboer, Jimenez, Ibanez, Reguilon, Ndidi, Kessie, Camavinga, Tsiankov, Liao, and Harry Kane. Obviously, Harry Kane up top. There's some partnerships forming here. I'm looking to see this defensive one come alive. Also, this right-hand side come alive. But we've got some new players in some of these positions, so I'm not expecting the relationships to be there. In my opinion, this is obviously the best start in 11 we've had. We've grown. We're a better team. As you can see, the balance of the stars, according to my coaches, is very good. As you can see, Harry Kane is wanted by Manchester United. So that'll be interesting to see if we can hold him off from that transfer this season. So if you look at the bench, guys, we've still got Joe Hart, Eric Dier, and Dombele, Edouard, Foyth, Hoiberg, Alderweireld, Sissoko, Giovanni Lo Celso, Moura. We've still got Sessegnon, Bergwijn, Doherty, Sanchez, Aurier. We've got lots and lots of depth, and I think that's where we're kind of lacking, is that sort of depth in each position. Obviously, the competitions remain the same: Carabao Cup, FA Cup, Champions League, and English Premier League. Season number 3, let's get it. Can we win a trophy this year? I would love to win a trophy this year. Season 3 is in the books, and unfortunately, despite, in my opinion, having the best team that we have had, in this rebuild so far. We finish in our worst position, probably with the worst points return, 70 points. I think we had 79 last season and 76 the season before. We do finish in fourth though. We do just about pip Arsenal to that Champions League spot. We're knocked out in the semi-final of the Champions League by Bayern Munich. Wow. 4-2 as well, relatively comprehensive looking at this. Bayern, obviously very good team. I don't think it's changed too much. Kaminski is a new player, but that's it. That is it. Everyone else who you see here, Upamecano is obviously a player that they have signed now. Everyone else here is a Bayern player, IRL, so fair play to them. Fair play to them, knocking us out. Hopefully they go on to win it. Oh, the final's not taking place yet. Interesting. Runner-up in the English FA Cup final. Five-one, to Liverpool. Sadio Mane going off, getting a 10 rating, scoring 4 goals in the final as well. Defense for Liverpool are very, very strong. Oh, they've signed David Alaba as well, and Bentancur. Okay. How are you going to beat Liverpool in this game, man? How are you going to beat Liverpool in this game? Knocked out in the fourth round of the Carabao by Southampton. But again, people didn't really, the board didn't really care about that. We still retain this Champions League football, which definitely must have helped with this debt and finance situation. Despite us going into even more debt, we've consolidated it. So it's just in one place. We're paying back 3.1 million a month until 2043. This debt is ginormous. This is probably one of the worst debts in the game, to be honest, at Spurs, and it's something I really, really didn't consider. Transfer revenue has gone down to 40% only because we've been scraping right on the limit of the wage budget. So this is going to be a rough season, guys. I'm hoping that what we can do moving into the next season is sort of just keep everybody, get them more familiar with everybody. Everyone gets a year older. Harry Kane's still ticking along for us, though. As a striker, he scored 33 goals for us in the season. That's okay. It's not as good a return as I would like out of 56 games from Harry Kane, to be perfectly honest. He's still wanted by Manchester United, so maybe that is a transfer that happens as we move into season 4. A much better performance in the Champions League, though, which I'm actually quite happy with. If we take a look at the Champions League, in our schedule, let's filter this just by the Champions League. We go through the group, Bayern, Celtic, and Olympiacos, relatively comfortably then going through that group. Yeah, 13 points equal to Bayern, which is fantastic. In the next round, though, Atletico Madrid, we beat them 5-0 at home and then 2-2 away from home. Manchester United, we beat them away at Old Trafford, 3-2. Dele Alli with the goal in the 82nd minute there, and then 2-2 at home, comfortably going through there, and then comprehensively beaten by Bayern Munich in both legs, 2-1, both at the Spurs Stadium and the Stadion München. Getting the job done very comprehensively. Season 4, I don't have a lot of money to work with. Are we going to keep Harry Kane? Only time will tell. We'll be back in a sec. Okay then, guys. So I have done some financial work to make some of these transfers happen. Eric Dier has now left the club for £26 million. He has gone back to Portugal. He's left Sporting. He is now back at FC Porto. Obviously, he does speak Portuguese. Sold him. He was unhappy with the game time that he was getting, so we sold him for £26 million. Serge Aurier has now gone to Trabzonspor for £8 million, which has allowed us at the other end of our field to sign Andre Onana. He comes in from Ajax. Obviously, he served his ban. We can now sign him. We signed him for £45 million. He can now play games for us. And I think this is an upgrade on Lloris. As you can see, Lloris down to a 2-star goalkeeper with his age. He is now 36 years of age. Obviously, Onana is a little bit of a step up. I like Onana as a sweeper keeper. Good aerial reach, good at one-on-ones, pretty good goalkeeping stats, very nice mentally, very good physically as well. I think he could be a nice little option for us. And we also signed Dani Ceballos on a free transfer. We've not had a lot of free transfers this year in this rebuild. So Dani Ceballos coming in as a ball-playing midfielder to play as that Mazzalo sort of role or DLP. I think he could be a nice little addition, especially for free. We're only paying him 95k. Only 95k. We're paying him 95k a week in wages, but we didn't pay a transfer fee for him. Real Madrid, we're releasing him. So we bring him in as another option. obviously competitions are the same four that we've been in for the majority of this save so far. In terms of the schedule, we've kind of powered through preseason. Losing to AC Milan's a little bit of a disappointing one. We need to get things right this year. I think we need to really push picking up a bit of silverware. I think I've never gone four seasons without winning a trophy in a rebuild, so hopefully this is the year that we actually finally get things sorted. If we take a look at our debts and loans, it's just going up, guys. Just going up. Some of this transfer debt because we owe installments. But £811 net debt is a big yikes. It is a big yikes. In terms of the club vision, this is what they expect from me this season. Champions League first knockout round, qualify for the Europa League in the Premier League, which is absolutely ridiculous. Semi-finals of the FA Cup, don't care about the Carabao. Let's have a look at the Premier League. Obviously, we've not really strengthened as much as we have done previously. We're at 14-1 to win the league. They expect us to finish in fifth again. And we no longer have one of the best players in the media Dream 11, because apparently Alexander Isak is better than Harry Kane. Let's agree to disagree, shall we? Liverpool signed their striker. They've also signed Kvaratskhelia as well. Liverpool are going to be a tough one to beat this season. That's for damn sure. So we will simulate the season. I'll be back in a second. Fingers crossed. Can we win a trophy in season number four? Let's get it. Okay. Season four is done, and we finally won a trophy. It wasn't the Premier League. It wasn't the Champions League. We have won the FA Cup with Spurs. If Omega Luke's old man was watching this, he'd be buzzing. He loves the FA Cup. He loves his Tottenham. So we finally done it. We've won the FA Cup. We beat Manchester United 1-0 in the final. Juan Foyth, the man for the big occasion, on as a substitute, popping the goal in off of a set piece. Oh, Manchester United, by the way. Simon Coco, them here. This front line, this front four is ridiculous. Pogba and Bruno behind it. Mad. Absolutely mad, this Man United team, I will say. But we win the FA Cup, which is nice. Knocked out in the fourth round of the Carabao Cup by Aston Villa. Disappointing, losing that one 3-1 at home. We made it to the semi-finals of back-to-back Champions Leagues. This time knocked out by Liverpool. Relatively comprehensively, actually. 4-1 on aggregate. Can I see the first leg? Let's have a look in here. The first leg of the Champions League. We lost 4-1 away. Dani Ceballos scored the goal for us. Mane again. We just can't hold on to Sadio Mane. Salah, Isak, and Sadio Mane with the goals. This front line, we must have some injuries, man. Dele Alli playing on the right wing is not it. But absolutely comprehensively bossed at Anfield. Two shots for us, one shot on target. I'm very surprised that we even scored a goal. Fair play to Dani Ceballos for doing that one. In terms of the Premier League, though, let's dive into the Premier League. Our highest points return in this rebuild so far, if we open up the stages, Manchester United win back-to-back Premier League titles with 93 points, which is fair play. We finish with 85 points, which, as I said, is our highest points return so far. A goal difference looking much better than previous in terms of goals conceded. Obviously, the addition of Onana has helped that. Onana with Ibanez and Jimenez in front of him. It's a nice little triangle of defenders and goalkeeper. I'm very, very happy with those. But we finish inside the top four. Liverpool drop out for the first time. They've not finished inside the top four. Southampton creeping in as well. Absolutely ridiculous. We're making good progress, so it feels like. We are better than we're better than we were last year with barely any signings. Onana's the top goalkeeper in the Premier League. He kept 19 clean sheets, so obviously spending the money on him was worth it. So I'm hoping next season number five could be the biggie. In terms of the Champions League, I'm always intrigued when we go quite far in the Champions League just to see how we got on. So we go through the group. We were in Group H with Dortmund, Benfica, and Besiktas. So not the easiest group, but we go through comfortably. 5 wins, 1 draw. Only 6 goals against there. Then we then knock out Barcelona. Wow. On away goals. Camavinga scores after 1 minute at the Nou Camp. And then we draw 0-0 at home. We then knock out Lyon. It's probably a rather relatively favourable tie, I would say. Lyon in the quarterfinals, beating them 4-2 away and then 6-1 at home. That is an absolute thrashing. Harry Kane with a hat-trick there. Fair play to him. And then getting dismantled by Liverpool in the semi-finals is disappointing. Do Liverpool win the Champions League? We don't know. They're playing Manchester United. It's an all-England tie. Gutted. Gutted that we could not be a part of that. So four seasons are in the books. We finally picked up our first trophy. It is an FA Cup. It's not the Premier League. It's not the Champions League. It's going to be the last season, fifth and final season. I'll be back for that with my transfer update in just a sec. Right then, guys, we are about to go into season number five, and I spent £0. But we've brought in three fantastic players. We've brought in Theo and Lucas Hernandez, both on free transfers. Theo Hernandez was frustrated that his contract at AC Milan was about to expire. He wanted a new deal. Ultimately, didn't get it. So we managed to sign him in the January for a free transfer, which is great, January last season. We also brought Marcus Edwards back to the club, a former Tottenham player, spent some time in Portugal. Looks like a decent little option for us. He's cover, that's all he is. He's listed as a fringe player in terms of squad playing time. He can play on both wings, is what, kind of what I needed, a little bit more depth. Lucas Hernandez is here as well, the Bayern, former Bayern player, centre back, can play fullback as well. Again, depth, 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 that's what we want. We let some players go on free transfers as well. We had some big transfers on the way out as well. Wilfred Ndidi has gone to Liverpool. They've bought another player from us. That happened at the end. Sorry, that looks like that happened in January last season. So my bad, guys. I completely forgot to bring you guys the Wilfred Ndidi departure. He left for Liverpool for £44.5 million. In terms of the tactic and the team going into the final season of this rebuild, this is the best 11. Onana, Hatebor, Jimenez, Ibanez, Reguilon, Camavinga, Kessie, and Ndombele, Tsiankov, Liao, and Harry Kane up top. This is it. This is all we've got. I'm giving it everything. In terms of preseason, we had a good preseason. We were unbeaten in preseason. We always seem to stumble against AC Milan, man. I don't understand it. We then took on Manchester United. They were Premier League winners. We were FA Cup winners in the Community Shield. We beat them 2-1. Harry Kane with the two goals for us. And as I mentioned, this Manchester United team is ridiculous. It's got even better. They've got Milinkovic-Savic. They've got Grealish. The depth that this Manchester United team have, they've gone back to back in the Premier League, is just ridiculous. But obviously we've got the Premier League to compete for. These are the competitions we're in. Obviously we won the Community Shield. It's just happened. Carabao Cup, English FA Cup, Champions League, and the Premier League, guys. So it's going to be an interesting one. We've got some players that are wanted as well. Harry Kane finally still has not gone to Manchester United. So I'm hoping that he remains at Spurs and could well be a club legend if we can lift that Premier League trophy or a Champions League. To be honest, I'd probably even settle for the FA Cup again, back-to-back FA Cups. Let's see what season five has to bring. Now, I don't usually do this, guys, but I have to bring you a transfer update that happened towards the end of the summer window. Davinson Sanchez is gone. He has gone to Aston Villa for 21 million. It could rise to 27. But the big one, Eduardo Camavinga is now a Real Madrid player. Obviously, he wanted to go to Madrid. It's where he is actually in real life. He has left Ren. He is at Real Madrid in real life now. 120 million they offered me. This was in the January, so I had to let him go. That's a massive amount of money, and I went out and spent it. And not only did I spend it, I spent it on a new gen as well. So welcome, Simeone Abuchi. This is the Italian under 21 international. He has come through FC Cologne somehow. We spent the 120 million that we sold Camavinga for on this guy. And I think he's a good little addition to the team. He's gone in. He's been a very good player for us. As you can see, 16 appearances in all comp, 5 goals, 3 assists for a player that came in January. He's only 20 years of age. He's the best midfielder in the squad by a long, long chalk. I have to say, guys, it's been a good season. So, competitions. We want some silverware. Everyone's happy. Spurs have won some silverware. We win the Premier League with 84 points. It's not our best points return, but it was enough to get the job done in the Premier League, pipping Manchester City to the title by just a point. We had the goal difference covered anyway. We go into the Club World Championship because we're winners of the Champions League. It took 5 seasons, but we're there. We got there. We spent a ridiculous, an exorbitant amount of money, but we got there. We beat Liverpool on penalties in that final. Unfortunately, knocked out in the FA Cup. We didn't retain it. Knocked out by our North London rivals in the fifth round. Knocked out by Arsenal 2-1 at the Emirates. Runners up in the Carabao Cup, though, losing that final to Manchester United. Let's dive into that one. Yusuf Demir getting the job done in the 87th minute with the winner there. Relatively even on balance of things, but the youngsters of Manchester United getting the job done for them, and then obviously the Community Shield I showed you before we got to this stage. So let's have a look at the Premier League first. I like the Premier League. As I said, definitely not our best return in terms of points. That came last season, where we had 85 there. Yeah, 85 last season was our best points return, but 84 was enough to win the Premier League title this season. Definitely locked things up in terms of defense. 6 draws, 6 losses, and 26 wins. Very, very good. Very, very happy with it. Liverpool scoring 101 goals is ridiculous. They should have won more games. They should have been higher up in the league table, but unfortunately, they weren't. Barnsley have made it into the Premier League for this season, and were relegated alongside Crystal Palace and Fulham. So, Premier League champions, Champions League champions. Let's take a look at that Champions League run in this fifth and final season. First of all, Group F, we go through. We were in a group with Porto, Villarreal, and Trabzonspor. Perfect group for us. We go straight through relatively easily. 5 wins, 1 draw, only 4 goals conceded. Love to see it. We move on into the knockout stages for the second year in a row. We knock out Barcelona in the first knockout round. We take on Barcelona at the Nou Camp. We pump 4 past them. Liao, Højbjerg, Tsiankov, and Harry Kane getting the job done. We drew 3-3 back at home, but it doesn't really matter. The 4 goals scored at the Nou Camp is enough to go through. RB Leipzig in the quarterfinals. We beat them 1-0. Harry Kane penalty at home getting the job done. Then we go away. We draw 2-2. And we go through. The away goal's doing us real good there. We take on Chelsea in the semi-finals, 3-0 at home. Jimenez, an own goal, and Ndombele with the goals there. And then we win 3-2 at the Bridge as well. Harry Kane coming up trumps with the brace. 2 goals. But it's the final, and there was a reason why I had to show you this, right? Bucci, who we signed, scored in the 92nd minute. The new gen that we spent £120 million on scored in the 92nd minute to send it to extra time, because they scored the winner in the 89th minute. Absolutely ridiculous. Liverpool throwing everything that they've got at us. Look at this team, by the way. Alisson, Trent, Gomez, Van Dijk, Guardiola playing at left back. Fabinho, I don't know who this guy is. I'm probably going to get slammed for not knowing who he is. No, he's a new gen. That's fine. He's come through Bayern. He looks disgusting, by the way. Playing alongside David Alaba. They've signed Ansu Fati. How much did they sign Ansu Fati for? 106 million. Salah and Alexander Isaac, who they spent a ludicrous amount on, I'm sure. 64 million. Wow. This Liverpool team, very, very strong. The attack not doing the business for the Spurs team, but the defense definitely did. Onana at an 8.8. Let's have a look. Isaac and Sadio Mane missed their penalties in the shootout. Salah, Ansu Fati, and Fabinho scored. And for Spurs, we went 5-for-5. Four for four. Harry Kane, Kessié, Lo Celso, and then Marcus Edwards coming back to Spurs, scores the penalty to win them the Champions League trophy. Mad. Absolutely mad. We win the Champions League in the fifth and final season. We win the Premier League in the fifth and final season. Hopefully you guys have enjoyed this rebuild. I've got enough time for 2 more, I think, before Football Manager 22 comes out. So do let me know down in the comments who you would like me to rebuild in these 2 rebuilds before we move into FM22 content. If you have enjoyed today's rebuild, guys, please do drop a like on it down below. It really does mean a lot. I'm going to set a like target for this one. I'd like to set a like target of 100 likes. Well, let's go for 100 likes for this Spurs rebuild. Ultimately, you Spurs fans should love this. We've won the Premier League in the end. We've won the Champions League. We won the FA Cup last season. Very, very good rebuild. If I do say so myself. We didn't win stuff as quickly as I would have liked, but we got over there in the end. If you are new around here and picking up my content for the very first time, don't forget to subscribe to the channel down below and ring that bell so you're told each and every time that we upload a video to the channel, because there's some very, very interesting stuff coming for FM22 and you guys are not going to want to miss it. But until next time, guys, take care of yourselves, take care of each other. I'll see you on another one very, very soon.